You know, being thankful for what we do have really helps us get through the times when we don't have what we'd like to have. I'm going to say it again. Being thankful for what we do have helps us make it through the times when it's difficult because we have needs that are not being met yet. Our words of gratitude, I wrote this down and I colored it in because I said it and I like it. Our words of gratitude in the face of suffering, especially unjust suffering, are a stronger proof of our trust in God more than any other thing that I know of. When you're going through something unjust, unfair, unkind, it's just not right, and you can still thank God on those days and really mean it, that's a very strong proof that you have your trust in God. Psalm 103:20 says that angels hearken to the word of God. They don't hearken to our complaining. You've got a lot of angels that you could put to work in your life by just complaining a lot less and giving a lot more thanks. We're all so much more blessed than what we think that we are many times. Amen. It was never God's intent for people to suffer. When he put Adam and Eve in the garden, he had great plans for nothing but their joy and good days. It wasn't God that messed it up. It was people that messed it up. We've got to quit blaming God for things that he's not responsible for. Don't ever say when you have a problem, well, God, don't you love me? Don't ever say that. In Romans 8, it says, don't let anything separate you from the love of God that is found in Christ Jesus. Not trouble or trials or seemingly unfair things. Don't ever say, well, God, don't you love me? The very fact that he sent Jesus to die for your sins is proof enough that he loves you to last us a whole entire lifetime. And I know there are a lot of people, especially watching by TV, and maybe you don't know as much about the Bible as some of the people in this room. And to be honest, we're glad to be here to preach to them, and them being here is important, but you are also important. And one of the main reasons why I'm doing this is because of all the numbers of people that we can reach today through the media. And I want you to know that irregardless of what you're going through, God sees you, he knows you, he cares about you, he's got a good plan for your life, and God is not the source of your problems. The thief, Satan, only comes to kill, steal, and destroy, but Jesus said, I came that you might have and enjoy your life and have it in abundance to the full until it overflows. And God will help you if you will let him.
We hope you enjoyed this teaching. To get more from Joyce, make sure to subscribe so you don't miss a thing.